children, and we think to ourselves, he wouldn't be where he is right now if I had done what I was supposed to do back then. She wouldn't be gripped up and caught up in a situation if I had listened to God initially and listened to his voice and did what he asked me to do. Am I talking to anybody? Or is this just my own personal situation? You see, what happens is that if we don't become obedient to God, we can negate some promises that God has for us. If we just do what God has asked us to do, God would bless us. God all along in this text is getting Abram ready to be the father of many nations. It doesn't look like it right now, but the bottom line is God has to allow us to go through some stuff in order for us to get ready for what he has for us. Abram couldn't do what he needed to do if he'd not gone through what God had for him to go through. Excuse me. I said I needed 5 minutes, right? I'm over by a couple of minutes, but just bear with me for a moment because I'm trying to help somebody today. Because some of us get stuck on stupid and get caught up in a situation that we could be further along, but the reality of it is that something grips us up and we can't move. So I went back and I did the historical research on the peace that Terah was in, because I wanted to know what was in Haran that grabbed him and caused him to stay. There was much prostitution, cult of worship, all kinds of stuff right there in the midst of this city that so gripped him up that he couldn't go where God asked him to go. And some of us in stations in our lives are gripped up in a situation we can't move from here because something has caught our attention. I don't know what it is that has called you up, but there is something that has you stationed where you are. And it may not be where God wants you to be. And now you are wrestling with what if. And so the text tries to help us understand that when we become obedient with God, God will bless us and move us along. Immediately after they discover that God is trying to move them, now God is blessing them. God has his eye on Abram. And just as God had his eye on Abram, God has his eye on you. Yes. I'm finished. But there's a story. There was a young boy that played for the university football team. And the young boy never got a chance to play. He wasn't large in stature, wasn't the fastest guy on the team. His coach had watched him and noticed that he wasn't the biggest, fastest player on the team, and therefore he mostly spent his time on the bench. But his daddy came to every game. Story had it that they were at an away game, and while they were there, a letter came or arrived to the coach, and the coach had to take it to the young boy. In this memo, it says, "Son, your dad has died." While he's at an away game, his father has died. Coach said to the boy, "Look, I'm going to let you go home, and then you don't have to worry about coming to Saturday's game. Just take time for your own needs." After he had gone and buried his dad and suffered a little while, he came back to the team, and they were at another away game. And while there, they were being beat so badly, the boy went up and said to the coach, "Coach, let me go in. No, boy, you can't go in right now. We need to keep our best players on the field. He was tenacious in asking over and over again, can I go in? Let me go in. And finally, the coach came in and said, okay, get your helmet and go in. The boy went in and got on the field. And the first thing you know, he begins running the ball and makes a touchdown. The next thing you discover is the game is tied. By the end of the game, there's a pass that is thrown, and now he's playing defense. He intercepts the pass and runs it from one end to the other end of the field. After the game, they're in the locker room, and the boy is in the deep corner crying away, but at the same time celebrating. And the coach said, boy, I want to know, what got into you this morning? And the boy looked at the coach and he said, well, coach, it was my daddy.
Yes, sir.
All those years, my daddy came to the game. And he sat there celebrating with me at the game. Uh-huh. But what I didn't tell you was that my daddy was blind. Woo! And for the first time after all these years, my daddy's in heaven, and right now, my daddy's alive. He's on me. For the first time, my daddy's able to see everything that I've done. I just stopped by to let you know that your father's eye is on you. Be blessed this morning. Come on, stand. I'm tired of this.